أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters of Masjid Salam and beyond السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته we still with the story of Saba and the change that happened because disbelieving in Allah's ni'mah not being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Not to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لقد كان لسبأ في مسكنهم آية. They had the two gardens. Allah Azza wa Jal made it a great sign. And they were the talk of the people around them at that time. But they disbelieved in Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah Azza wa Jal make the dams that used to engineer the irrigation and make that beauty existent collapse. And then everything is flooded around them. The only way for you is to join. Is to join the class. So we are settled. Alright, that's Sheikh Musa here. He will inshallah be good. Right? He will be good inshallah. Sit and watch.
I want this. Baba is
Simu. Simu, yes. Okay.
Baba
and Simu.
It's white.
Inshallah.
It's Baba eyes.
I don't know whether this is like a good thing or a bad thing because of the COVID-19 and saying from home. So anyways, they disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah changed everything from good to bad, from positive to negative. Believing in Allah is positive. You might go through hardship, which is negative, but believing in Allah is positive, doesn't change. So if you do not get positive in the dunya, get it in akhirah. But for sure you have the positive, which is the iman. So you're not losing anything after all. You have one positive that does not change. If that positive changes, you may have the positive of the dunya, but negative in akhirah. You may have negative here, and it also will be negative in akhirah. So there is no winning situation here. The only winning situation is to have the stable faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what Allah Azza wa Jal said after that destroyed and the fruit is not good fruit anymore, the vegetation is not good vegetation anymore, they are flooded and they lost everything. Not only that, they said, you know why we travel. And Allah Azza wa Jal made between them and the other, any other destination, Quraan Zahira. Yani Allah Azza wa Jal made like stations for them to stay and rest and all of that when they are traveling. But they disbelieved in that and said, we want to travel like other people. فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا بَاعِدْ بَيْنَ أَسْفَرِنَا وَظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ They kind of transgressed themselves. فَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَحَدِيث Allah make them like an example for everybody in punishment. وَمَزَّقْنَاهُمْ كُلَّ مَمَزَّقٍ They lost their power, their authority, their status among the communities and everything. Subhanallah. So the lesson for us here, in short, as an individual, if Allah give you a ni'mah, have the shukr of that ni'mah and be careful and be afraid that it can go away from you in a blink of an eye. In blink of an eye. See how free we were. We're moving and going around the world and going vacations here and there. Who was vacation now? I was checking the tickets to overseas. You find $500 ticket round trip. Can you imagine that? In the season that it used to be $1,300 and $1,400 and $1,500, and they cannot find people to go. There are destinations people don't want to go, and they were eager to go. Who wants to travel for a vacation now? Who wants to go on a beach right now? Who wants to go to Disneyland right now? Who wants to travel? Go in an airplane and travel. Everybody's afraid and scared. Even when you say Masjid is open or something like that, how many people will go? You see? So Allah can take from you that freedom in a blink of an eye. Can take from you the health in a blink of an eye. Can take from you the wealth in a blink of an eye. Can take your life in a blink of an eye. So the only thing we have is to have shukr to Allah for whatever we have and pray for Allah to give us barakah and what we have. May Allah give us all barakah and what we have. Allah give us the ability to thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm sorry for this background. And may Allah Azza wa Jalla reward you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.